So here I've got a little business. It's a spa business. And in the spa, we have three different kind of types of services or products. We've got massages, we've got products which you can actually buy, and then we've got these day packages. And over here, we've got an order form where we want to input first the category. So whether it's a massage product or day packages, and then the item within that category, a quantity, we'll get a price, and then a final cost, and then the total we're going to charge the customer, including a discount. So I'm going to start by unhiding these cells, and in this category list, I'm going to take our three different categories, and I'm going to copy and paste the values. Here, the first category cell, I'm going to use some data validation. So I'm going to go to my data validation list, and then the source are going to be these three cells. I'm going to press OK, and then I'm just going to select the first one, so massage. Okay, now over here, I'm going to create a match formula. And so if you're not familiar with match, check out my match video. It's a function which looks up a value in an array and returns the position. Now, my lookup value is going to be this category. And then I'm going to put a comma. The lookup array will be these three cells, and I need to anchor the rows. And then my match type will be zero at the end. I'll close the brackets, press enter, and it gives us a one. And I'm just going to copy that down. We'll get some NAs, which is fine. This is essentially saying massage appears in the first cell of that array. If I was to change this to products, it appears in the second, etc. Now I'm going to go back to massage, and then in item, I need to put in some more data validation. And so really in this field, we now want to be able to select one of the massage items and forget about all these. And so if I go here and I go back to data validation, and I'm going to choose a list again. Now for source, I'm actually going to have to put a formula in there. I'm going to put a choose formula. So if you're not familiar with choose, check out my choose video. It's a lookup function where we're going to start by selecting this one, and then I'm going to pick the three arrays of my different items. It should be firstly this, hold down control, select the second one, and then select the third. And you can see in this formula, we had J6, which was this cell here. We need to actually take off this dollar sign because we're going to be dragging this this data validation down. We've then got this array of cells, a comma, that array of cells, a comma, and then that array of cells. So that's this array of cells, that array of cells, and that array of cells. If I press OK and press this drop down, we've now got full body rebalance down to Indian head, which are these different cells here. If I was to go and change this to products and then go back to item, I now have body detox salt scrub down to restorative body oil, which is this set of products. And then finally, if I was to change this to day packages, then you've guessed it, we've got renew day to peaceful day. And so essentially the data validation in this cell is seeing a three, and then the cells which the data validation list are referring to is the third array of cells that we've chosen in that choose formula. Okay, so let's just put renew day. Quantity, we can just chuck in anything, let's put two. In unit price, now I want to look up the price of a renew day in this list, and so I'm going to put an index and match function in. Check out my index and match function. It's the combination of two functions which are super versatile for looking up information and really vital for kind of advanced analysis and modeling. So I start off by selecting an array where I'm going to find my price. I'm going to anchor that. Now I need to give the index function a row number, and I'm going to use match for that. And I'm going to select the item value, and then the lookup array will be the different items here. I'm going to anchor that and then put in a zero and then close the brackets. And it's now looking up 240, which is the renew day price. If I was to change this to wellness day, it now returns 225, yeah? Again, I could just change this to massages and deep tissue, and it looks up 60, right? Now, so for the cost, I'm going to put equals the quantity multiplied by the unit price, and that is therefore the cost that we get to. Right now, I'm just going to copy all of this down. Now that has copied down the data validation and also the formulas, but I'm going to go back and just delete these cells. Now we're getting a load of NAs here, which is ugly, and it's also going to cause us problems in this subtotal when we come to sum this column. And the reason we're getting them is because the match function doesn't like this kind of empty cell and looking up over here. So I'm going to wrap this formula in an if NA. And I'm going to put comma zero, close the brackets, and then I'll copy this down. And all those NAs actually now turn to zero. Now with the subtotal, I'm gonna just use a shortcut. I'm gonna press Alt equals, and it creates a sum formula referencing all the cells above it. So we've now got a subtotal. Now for this discount, I'm going to enter in a bit more data validation. So I'm going to set a maximum discount that we can use in this form, and that's going to be 20%. And in this discount cell, I'm going to put in some data validation. Like we saw before, it's going to be a decimal, and it's going to have a maximum value of that cell, and let's just say a minimum value of zero. So I'm going to press OK, and again, I can put 20% in here, but I can't put 21%. It's greater than the max, so we'll leave that as 20%. And now the total is the subtotal multiplied by 1 minus the discount. And so now this form, we could just go down and we can select basically just some other items, really whatever we want. We'll select a few here, and let's go back to massage. And we'll say 3 of those, 4 of those, and 1 of those. And we can see the unit price is being looked up for each of these items and then multiplied by the quantity to give us a cost. And we get a subtotal, then we reduce it by the discount, and we have a total. And so that is data validation being used in a form, and we're using some dynamic data validation lists here, where the values that we can select in this dropdown are dependent on the category.